We are going to do a different type of reading today. I've just been trying to switch it up. I hate the same thing every day, okay? I hate, what's that called? Monotony, okay? I think I hate anything with mono involved. But that's for a different day. I'm only reapplying this because I already had it on. And it's coming off, so it's starting to look weird. So I'm not that vain, you guys. Not that vain. All right, so we're going to see what your person thinks about you. Yeah, we're going to see what they think about you, honestly. And you guys, look, if you're going to be triggered, don't come the fuck over here with that shit, okay? I'm so tired of sensitive-ass fucking people. Like, I'm sensitive, but, like, look, I like the truth. Just keep it, give it to me straight. All right. Only thing I don't like straight is my women and my liquor. Okay? So, everything else for the most part, I like straight. All right. So, let's see. Can you guys hear me good? I guess you guys can hear me fine because people are putting laughing emojis, so you guys are definitely hearing me. There's something wrong with me, you guys. I'm really trying to figure it out. Lately, it's been a struggle, you know what I'm saying? I want to say happy Independence Day to Nigeria since I'm Nigerian, okay? Confirmed, so I get to be included. I don't really want to be included a lot, but that's something I want to be included in, you know, since I'm Nigerian. All right, you guys, remember, okay, so you know I posted in my story, y'all that follow my personal page. Remember the other night I said that this dude asked me to marry him, right? So he's Nigerian, and he found me on YouTube years ago, right? Like, long story, right? And from the moment we met, he told me I was Nigerian. This is like in 2016, he was like, you're Nigerian. I'm like, no, I'm not, right? Why get this paperback that said I'm Nigerian? I was like, nah. I was like, yo, you gotta get the fuck away from me because I ain't had none of that energy till you came along with that shit. But he was right. I sent that shit to him. Oh, long story. You guys know I got stories for days, but you know, I'm a 50-year-old woman. So, all right. So pile A, let's go ahead and get into your reading. Let's see what this person thinks about you. Oh my God, we have the fuckboy. What? So you guys got the fuckboy. All right, Polly, let's get to it. Inexplicably confident, shameless, fearless. Your romantic gestures include cock blocking, asking for naked pics, and avoiding relationships. Will the same tactics continue to get you laid or bring you sexual misconduct suits? Ad sales and places ad sales and your totem is unused DJ equipment. So either y'all are fucking with a fuckboy or y'all are a fuckboy or a fuck girl. Okay, look, you gotta accept who you are. This is what this person thinks about you. Okay, I don't know. Okay, maybe they think that you are susceptible to fuckboys because you're fucking with them. Maybe they know that they're a fuckboy and they know that you are gullible to fuckboys because you obviously fucking with their ass. I don't know. Okay, let's see what they think your dark qualities are. I don't know if I can post this on YouTube. People gonna be in their feelings over there. Super butt hurt land. Revenge in reverse. Yeah, this person feels like you're very... Yeah, this person... I feel like this with the revenge in reverse. I feel like this person feels like you're docile or you're soft. Hey, Fancy Patrice. That's my mentee right there. She's doing awesome. Go check her out. I don't know what her business stuff is, but yes. Because I need to get her stuff. I actually got her stuff. I need to open this up and look at it. I need to ask you about that before I do it. So I'm going to text you actually. Good thing you popped on here. So this person, pile A. Sorry guys, back to the reading. Pile A. Revenge in reverse. This person feels like you are kind of soft. Like you, yeah, I'm sorry. You picked two piles. I'm sorry, I didn't put that in the title. It's pile A or pile B. Pile A or pile B, one or the other. So they think that you are pretty gullible or you are naive, like you're naive or you're soft. I'm getting that with revenge in reverse. Like you are a hopeless romantic. I'm getting hopeless romantic. OK. Yeah. Like you might be susceptible to narcissists. You may be an empath. Yeah. Like, you just keep fucking with fuckboys. So this person may feel like you have a bad history with people. Like, you have a bad history with relationships, or you don't know how to pick good men. So I feel like this person is telling you that they're a fuckboy or a fuckgirl, whoever this person is, Pile A. What the hell is wrong with y'all readings? Pile A, Lord. Shit. Okay. I ain't got time for that. But yeah, they think that you have, like, you have, like, you are glutton for punishment when it comes to fuckboys or fuckgirls, right? Spirit, no, I got shit to do today. This person feels like you're destined for something greater, though. So maybe you guys are supposed to be using your empathy for skills. They feel like you are destined for greatness. They feel like you're too good for them. Let me tell you that shit. They feel like you're too good for them. Spirit, no, I got shit to do. That means that you got shit to do and you shouldn't be fucking with them. They know that. This person thinks that about you, okay? This is what they think. I'm just the messenger. Don't shoot the messenger, okay? Because she might shoot back. All right, anyway. Eight of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, they feel like you're not working on something that you should be working on. It's because he looks like Elvis, not that. Elvis was a January Capricorn. Moving along. Anyway, Eight of Pentacles in reverse. So this person definitely feels like you're not working on things that you're meant to be working on. You could be a Virgo or a Scorpio, a Cancer or a Pisces. This person feels like you're sad a lot, or like you're very emotional. Like, this person feels like you could be doing other things with your time. Like, you spend too much time on emotions and they feel like you're sad over them. Like, this person, if this person does shit to you, they know that you do shit. They know that they do shit to hurt you, but with the revenge in reverse, they feel like you're not going to check them for it, or you're not going to stop fucking with them. I'm glad this ain't my file. All right, moving right along. So Five of Cups, yeah, this person feels like they can keep coming back and doing the same thing over and over to you guys. That's what this person is thinking, okay? It's not what I'm saying. It's what they think. King of Wands, definitely. Aries, Leo, Sag. This person, you boost this person's self-esteem. This is the ultimate fuckboy. This person is probably even married for some of you. So they might brag to their friends. See, the strength in reverse, this could be a Leo. This is saying that you have no, like, resolve. You have no... You know, raw, like, you know, I'm nice as they come, but I got two sides to me. That's all I'm gonna say. All right, I was born on a full moon. All right, sun and moon, completely different places. All right, you might get one side, you might get the other, but they're trying to say that they never get this other side of you. If you have that about you, they've never seen it. This person's probably married, or they deal with other people. They feel like this is a King of Wands, okay? So they could be a Capricorn, an Aquarius, a Scorpio, or a fire sign, but you boost this person's ego. Okay, just saying, I didn't do it, guys. I'm telling you, the Queen of Wands and the Hierophant, though. So this person sees you as powerful. Some of you guys, this person feels like you should be in a high level position. They do think that you're beautiful, though. This person also spies on you a lot. If you are a fire sign that does tarot or something like that, or you do something where you're out in front of people teaching something, they watch you do that, or whatever you do for work for some of you. I will say that if this person is married, they would actually rather be married to you, but it's almost because they feel like they would be able to do what the fuck they want to do with you. They do feel like you guys match each other, though, so I don't know what the fuck that's about, you guys. I don't know. I don't know who the hell this person is. They are just naturally a fuckboy. I think that's what this person... So it's like this person knows that you deserve better, but they don't want you to go get better. They don't want you to leave them alone. They feel like you're their person, but they feel like you deserve better than them because they're a fuckboy. But you need to check this person, Pile A, because I don't know who out here thinking y'all a little bitch. You know, I tell people all the time, my mom ain't raised no bitch. And if she did, it was my brother. It ain't me, honey. Ace of Swords and the Seven of Pentacles. So sexually, this person is like, they always lurk. This person is very into you sexually. Like, you may not even know when this person is watching you. The Page of Swords is here twice. Yep. This person watches you. Especially if you work with this person, okay? They wait until... If you have sex with this person, they cannot wait till the next time. Like, every time you guys have sex, they cannot wait till the next time. This person would, like, have sex with you every week if they could. But for a lot of you, this person's married, so they can't be doing that. You know what I'm saying? That's why I feel like you boost their ego. This person's probably controlled by their spouse or something. Like, they probably go home and live like a totally different life. But with you, they come off like this grandiose person because they're the King of Wands. Whew. All right, Pale. I'm trying to get the fuck out y'all energy because I'm sorry. That ain't for me. So I'm sorry if you pick pile A. If that ain't your reading, this ain't your reading. Don't pick pile B. Don't bring that energy over in pile B. Shit, hell. All right. So look, let me get it moving because I got to go help my friend move. I'm over here playing like I got time. All right. So the next one is the home brewer. So pile B, your person feels like you're the home brewer. Okay. I've never seen this card. I've never seen the fuckboy card either. So knowledgeable, your person feels, they think that you're knowledgeable, you're artisan, condescending. Yes, this might be my pile. No, we stop. Skillful. They feel like you're skillful. Your thirst for new tastes, knowledge, and bars with rotating taps fill you to the brim with joy. Okay, so your thirst for new tastes, knowledge, and bars with rotating taps fill you to the brim with joy. So this is definitely saying for those people who like to constantly do new things, like you want to pursue new things, you don't like to do the same thing, okay? But what is more intoxicating, a beard full of ideas or a heart full of golden lager? Whatever. I feel like I'm saying that wrong, but whatever. Place esoteric Wikipedia pages. The place is esoteric Wikipedia pages, gang. And then the totem is the humble brag. Swag. This is definitely my pile. This is me, okay? This is me. I don't know about the rest of this shit, but this is definitely me. I rock with that shit. Because I brag, but it's humble. It's real humble. I don't be telling nobody. I just let you see it. All right. Wikipedia. What? That's too funny. Esoteric. Always want to do new things. This is definitely my pile. All right. I like this energy already. Hopefully it ain't crazy like Polly. All right. Peaceful among the thorns. They said you cooler than the other side of the pillow, though. So some of y'all are middle children. You gotta be. I'm a middle child. Some of you guys have been through a situation or been through a lot in life, so you're cool under pressure. You're like the person that people go to rely on. People go to you to get shit done. People know that you are gonna get shit done, okay? You are cooler than the other side of the pillow. You don't get too razzled. And we have naked before the stars. So some of you guys might be influencers, Instagram models, Insta thoughts, you know, gang also, whatever. If not, you're an influencer or you're on YouTube. You don't gotta be any other thing. I'm just saying. In this deck, okay, it's the Insta-thought deck. It's the Insta-thought card. I'm just saying. Some of you guys just may be influencers. I'm just saying. Y'all know what? I've been thinking about starting my OnlyFans, y'all. I think I'm gonna start an OnlyFans. But I think I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna tell y'all later. That's for Freaky Friday. But yeah, I think I'm gonna start my OnlyFans. All right. Making shit manifest, the magician energy. So some of you guys are definitely witches or into the esoteric. You're very independent, pile B. They see you as independent. Some of them, they feel like you drive a nice car. I don't know why that's coming up, but that's the Chariot. The fuck it, I'll do it myself card is the Chariot. And they feel like you manifest very well. Some of you guys are business owners, or you're really good at making shit happen, all right? You can manifest literally through magic, or you're just very good at manifesting. You are very good at getting what you want. You're charismatic. The magician is also very bomb at sex. So if you've had sex with this person, I'm about to tell you why I said problem in a minute. If you had sex with this person, then they think you're the shit sexually. That ain't my problem though, is why I was about to say that. So you're definitely somebody who will leave somebody in a minute. Like you're someone who has discernment. You know what is your issue and what's not, okay? So you don't be babying motherfuckers. You know, that's what I be saying. People be wondering why my children talk so eloquently, because I never babied them. How I'm gonna talk baby talk to you and I'm not a baby? How is that gonna help you communicate with me? No, we're not doing baby talk. We skip that stage. I don't got time. All right, so we have the Four of Swords and we have the Lovers, Libra or Gemini. Some of you guys are air signs, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Three of Swords. This person feels like you're a heartbreaker, pal B. How you're influencing this person is you broke their heart. You separated from this person. You guys are on a break from this person, but they do feel love for you. This person does feel love for you. They also feel like you have choices in love. This person does see you as condescending, though. Like, I feel like this person feels like maybe you communicate better than them. I feel like this is their perception of you. I don't think that you're actually like that, because it's crazy. They say you're peaceful among the thorns, but then they say the Knight of Swords. So it could be that you are peaceful to an extent, but anytime you need to pop off, you will. Because you do have the fuck it, I'll do it myself card. So that's more of a person who was just cut people the fuck off and go what they gotta do. You might not even be hostile, but it depends. But a lot of you, this person does see you as condescending, okay? There's something about when you communicate, they don't feel like they can communicate on your level, all right? That's just what it comes down to. They might not ever say that, but Four of Swords, Three of Swords. Yeah, you're not talking to this person, or you guys are on some sort of break. So this person feels like you're a heartbreaker. I'm hearing Mariah Carey, heartbreaker. And there's the Star again. So like I said, some of you guys are influencers, or you're astrologers. You do something weird. Aquarians are always about a weird shit. See, King of Swords again. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. They feel like you can be cold. You can be cold. Some of you guys are bosses, or you would make good bosses or mentors. Some of you guys have a choice between this person and an air sign. This person feels like you have a cold side to you. Like, you will cut somebody off. You're very independent. Like, you don't need people. Like, this is somebody who's like, oh shit. Like, yeah, this is all about, even the Magician, this is single energy. Chariot, single. King of Swords, single. Yeah, this is somebody who feels like they can't match wits with you. So they may run from you. Like, if they know that you guys need to have a conversation, they don't like to argue with you, because this person doesn't feel like they can spar with you mentally. That's what I'm getting. All these swords. Yeah. Yeah. And that even said that, like, you, it said that in this card. The first thing was knowledgeable. All right. Sexually, I told you guys what I say earlier. The Magician. Why do I even use more than two cards? Like, I told you guys, sexually, the Magician. Like I said from this card, this person thinks that you are the shit sexually. You know all the fucking tools, okay? The Knight of Wands. This person will fuck you all the time, okay? If they could. All right? Just saying. A lot of these persons are Gemini. Yes. Nine of Pentacles. You are independent. Some of you guys have your own business. And I feel like this person realizes, like, you are a formidable opponent. Like, if there's a not talking thing going on, you can match them. Like, if this person wants to be cold, you'll match their energy. You match motherfuckers' energy. You guys are the moon. I'm the moon. That's why I don't resonate with fucking Leo. I match people's energy. Don't, like, people be acting like I just be tripping for no reason. I don't just trip for no reason. I just start spazzing for no reason. There, you did something. I reflect people's energy. So that's what this is. You're very independent. I feel like you broke this person's heart. This person does love you. Some of you, this person may have a choice, though, between you and an air sign. They may be going between you and a Gemini. And I feel like this person also feels like they can't get shit past you. Like, you know things as well. Yeah. You let go. You're someone who lets go and you have options. Yep. The Empress and the Seven of Cups. You let people, you have options. A lot of you guys are like bombshells or some shit like that. So pile B is totally different than pile A. Two totally different people, two different messages. Maybe you guys just needed to hear it. It is what it is. But I got to go, guys. I have to help my friend move. I'm already like behind. But I wanted to get this done because I didn't know what I was going to be back. So I love you all, and I will talk to you later. Bye.